Hubbard Luzinda, a father of a 13-year-old boy with autism, explains the challenges of raising an autistic child. He explains the frustrations, stigmatization, and psychological stress.
What we went through and the aspects of autism, which include, he was very violent, he was non-social, he couldn't talk, he couldn't speak. At night, he couldn't sleep. But all that has changed. He's now able to feed himself. He's now able to integrate socially. He speaks, he talks, he runs, he participates in sports. It's a whole different ball game right now.
Children with autism have delayed speech, find trouble expressing their needs and emotions, tend to stay alone, do things alone, and cannot look people directly in the eyes. They also have rotative behavior, follow routines, do things repetitively, and love the semblance of most things, and any change agitates them, because the area of the brain responsible for concentration, attention, speech, and memory is damaged. While speaking at the Autism Day celebrations, which have been held at Katikati Grounds in Kampala today, parents called for more support from the government, explaining that autistic people need to be included in education, and besides, timely intervention is critical in improving the children's overall development.
Personally, I'm a parent of a child with autism, 14-year-old. The challenges that we are mainly facing is lack of support. Lack of support, mainly because maybe the awareness is still minimal, and that is the reason why we are coming out here, to create awareness so that people can really understand this condition and come out to support. So support in terms of education system is not there, in terms of health system is not there, so it's really, really a big challenge to us. Our children can be able to go into school and be able to learn the basics or even excel in education, because autism has high functional autism, you know, that part of it, you know. So if a child is able to be helped, that is under early intervention, this child can come out and be very, very productive in his society or her society.
Research indicates that early intervention programs, which involve family training, speech therapy, hearing impairment services, physical therapy, and nutrition services, can greatly improve these children's lives. Dr. Prosy Nakanwaji, a member with the Autistic Society Uganda, said, because of more awareness, the country has continued to witness more cases of autism among the children.
Chris, we are seeing big numbers in hospitals, so we need all the help that you can get. Because at the moment, to be able to help these children, you have to do what they call early interventional therapy. In this country, all of us are living in the same economy. It is very expensive to put a child through therapy, you know. Yet we know that if these children are given the accommodative services and therapies and all the assistance, they can do well. If you may, the world's most brilliant person, you know, is on the spectrum. So we want to look out for the geniuses among us.
According to the Uganda Bureau of Statistics figures, autism prevalence is put at 70 out of 10,000 persons. Countrywide, about 388,000 suffer from autism, and in terms of regional share, the eastern region has the highest number of children at 113,000 and the lowest number in the northern region with 80,000 cases. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.